What's up, my sugar plum fairies? I hope you're having an amazing holiday season. And if you're not, that's okay too. In this video, I want to talk about depression and ways to cope with depression that comes during the holidays. A lot of what the media projects is that the holidays are a very happy and joyous and cheerful time, but that just is not the case for many people, and depression is actually very common during the holiday season and months. So in this video, I want to talk about depression during the holiday times and ways that we can cope and manage this depression that we know is going to come once December hits. So the truth is that the holiday season is difficult. It is not always happy for many people. Once people start to hear those Christmas songs on the radio and in the stores and in the mall, they actually want to vomit. It doesn't actually bring up those feelings of nostalgia that advertising companies want people to feel. Now, there are different reasons for feeling depressed during the holiday season. It can be stress, it is the weather. Like, if you notice when it starts getting darker, the days are shorter, the sun isn't there, you do feel slumpy. You do feel like you don't want to get out of bed. You don't have that glow because the sun gives us energy. We are human beings who thrive on the sun. We thrive on light. We need that vitamin D. And seasonal affective disorder is a very real thing. That's why people buy those lights that are extremely bright and then you can look at it to get that sunlight if you can't naturally get it. And also upping your intake of vitamin D can help with seasonal affective disorder because we get this vitamin D from the sun. For many people, the holidays is an anniversary of some sort, not those pleasant birthday or marriage anniversaries, but it can be a death anniversary of a parent, a grandparent, a loved one, and it just does not bring those nostalgic thoughts to mind. It brings those thoughts of sadness, and many of us want to retreat, go away from society, and just take this time to mourn. Some people feel extra anxious during the holidays because they know they're going to have to see their family and they're going to have to field all of these questions and intrusions about their life. You know, some people are getting asked, when are you going to have a baby? Or how is your career going? Or how is school going? And you just don't have any good answers and you don't want to get these personal and invasive questions. So people feel extra anxious. And on the opposite spectrum, people feel anxious because they don't have that family to spend Christmas with or the holidays with. They see on all the Hallmark movies that the holidays is for family, but if you don't have a lot of brothers or sisters or large typical family gatherings, you might get extra depressed during these holiday months. And I just wanted to say that it's a natural thing. A lot of people, a lot of people are feeling this way, not just you out there. I know that for many of my students, because if you didn't know, I'm a teacher, it is an extra sensitive time because some of them are dealing with family issues, like their families are not here in the US or in the immediate surrounding neighborhoods. They're far away and they haven't seen them for a long time. And this brings up, you know, feelings of sadness and depression. So that's why at school we really try to make it a cheery environment. So in this video, I wanted to give you some strategies on how to cope with this depression that you know is going to be coming up because of the holiday season. All right, so if you know that you're going to be sad or depressed during the winter and holiday months, I would say try to get outside on the nice days as much as you can. If you need to take a break during your lunchtime, take a walk outside, you see it's sunny, get out there. Soak up that sun. In the weekends, try to plan days where you go into nature or a boardwalk where there's sun, or just walking around the neighborhood, getting out in fresh air and getting that sunlight that we're lacking during this darker month is very important. I think it will rejuvenate you and give you some peace and fresh air, and it will really help with the stress and being inside of our minds and depression during this time. Plan ahead with some activities that you want to do and that bring you joy. Look for things that you know make you happy. If you like getting exercise and going to the gym, make sure you're making that a more frequent thing. If you want to get together with friends and family, be it in real life or in Zoom, and just being able to talk, that's very important. Talking out your feelings, getting them out so that someone can listen to you that you trust, is also very therapeutic. If you like to cook or bake or take a bike ride, make sure that you're thinking about the things that make you happy. Get away from focusing so much on the sadness and depression that you're feeling and try to shift that focus on how you can be happy. What are these things that you enjoy doing, and do more of those things. So some other ideas would be a solo hike in the forest, a bike ride, a pamper night where you take a nice bath, you relax with a movie, talking with a friend, retail therapy. Just think about the things that really make you happy. Now on the flip side of that, avoid things that make you aggravated. If it aggravates you to go to a store with so many people, don't do that. Just look for the things that could be triggers in your life and your depression and stay away from those as much as possible. So if you already feel sad and then you're doing things that make you angry, these two feelings could really mount inside of you and then create even more negative energy that's not good for you. Clean up your space so that you can feel calm and peaceful. If that means cleaning up your office or your bedroom or washing your sheets, since it's always so nice and refreshing to go into your bed with nice fresh sheets, or cleaning your refrigerator, or even washing out your car and the inside of your car, this will make you feel productive, which also combats depression, but also that clean space and that clean mind. And also put some candles around, make it smell good, and that will help you with, you know, feeling sad. So if your surrounding area is nice and pleasant and you like to be there, that is something that you can focus on. You can focus your gratitude on having a nice space and a clean area. So this next tip is to help you also if you're really busy during this time and you have so many things to do, but it is to plan out your meals ahead of time so that you've gone to the grocery store, you've gotten all the ingredients of things that you need that are healthy, and you will have pre-planned and prepped meals that you can eat during this time. Now, for depression, this is about healthy eating. If you're fueling your body with nutrients, nutrition that is healthy, and also vitamin D to help with the seasonal affective disorder and the lack of vitamin D we're getting from the sun, this will help your brain feel good. Nobody ever says they feel bad from eating healthy food. This is always a positive. So I'm just trying to give you ideas of how to create positive things in your life during this season so that the positive side outweighs the negative, depressing side. So on that line of thinking, another idea could be journaling. I've noticed that a lot of people say it's very therapeutic, getting your thoughts out. If you feel sad, it's cathartic. Sometimes you might cry when you're writing your journal prompts, but it's just a good idea to get your thoughts out there. And in addition to this, I would say take a page and write the things that you're grateful for. Even if it's just three things a day or even one thing a day, what is it that you are grateful for? We want to shift our mind from that negative, depressing side to what is going good in my life. What am I grateful for? So this next idea is for people who are feeling anxious for the family gatherings and the large family dinners. And it's to be prepared. Be prepared for the type of questions that you might get about your life that you feel uncomfortable answering, and be prepared with an answer. Be prepared to say something that is respectful, that is to the point, and says basically that you don't want to talk about this, that this is something private and you're handling it. I'm not saying to think about quips and quick jabs to say, you know, shut up, but find a way to be respectful to shut that conversation down that makes you feel uncomfortable. On another note, if you have a trusted family member, like a cousin or a sister, tell them that you feel uncomfortable about the family gathering and that you're going to need them to save you from these awkward situations. So tell them and give them a heads up that you might need them to save you. Like, you should have a code word like, oh, let's go try the Christmas cookies, or let's make coffee for everyone, so they can help remove you from these uncomfortable situations and questions that you don't want to get. So if your depression is coming because of the anniversary death of a loved one, that is really hard to deal with, but you do have to take that time to grieve. Lean into it, go visit their grave, write this person a letter. I would say put down all of your feelings that you want to tell them, that you want to communicate to this person. I think it will relieve a lot of stress and make you feel like you are talking to this person. My last tip for you guys for coping with depression during the holiday seasons is to rely on your good friends and family. Not everybody in your circle, but your very close friends and your very close family members, maybe one or two people, have them rely on them, call them, text them, use them as a source of strength for you so you can talk out your feelings and just get that support. It is so important to have support when you're feeling depressed, and if you can rely on family and friends, that's great. If you think you need to kick it up a notch, then you should be calling a therapist or somebody that you can talk to who has the knowledge of guiding you through the feelings that you have. Well, my jingle bells, if you like this video, please like this video. Subscribe down below for more videos like this. And in the meantime, I hope you are staying sane and safe during this holiday season. And remember, everything will be all right. Bye.